Our feast day for today is the fourth glorious mystery, the Ascension of the Lord. The Ascension cannot be understood separated from the Resurrection. The Ascension can only be understood in connection with Pentecost. Para baghong nandito ang Easter, nandito ang Pentecost, at sa gitna noon, naroon ang Ascension. Ang tanong po ay, ang Ascension po ba ay tulay lang? Tulay lang na nag-uugnay sa Easter at saka sa Pentecost? Hindi po. May sariling connection, may sariling kahulugan, may sariling kahalagahan ang Ascension ng Panginoon. Anong kahalagahan ng Ascension para sa ating buhay bilang tao? Mayroon pong tatlong expressions. Tayo bilang tao na nagkakaroon ng bagong kahulugan kapag iniugnay sa Ascension. Unang salita, I miss you. Yun ay sinasabi natin sa mahal natin sa buhay. I miss you. Yun ay sinasabi natin sa mahalaga sa atin. Pero kasama nun sa I miss you ay mayroong pagnanasa, mayroong kahilingan na sana ay maibalik natin yung kahapon. The apostles also told the Lord after Easter, Lord, we miss you. But the Lord told the apostles, do not cling to me. Huwag niyo kong hanapin sa kahapon sapagkat mayroon ng new normal. At ang new normal ay hindi na ako yung dati niyong guro, ako ay Panginoon na muling nabuhay. When we miss, let us remember there is a new relationship blooming. You miss the baby because the baby is now a lady. You miss the cocoon because the cocoon is now a butterfly. You miss the child because the child is now a professional. You miss your boyfriend is now your husband. You miss your childhood, you are now a grandmother. Ibig sabihin po, kapag meron tayong gustong ibalik na kahapon, alalahanin lang natin, meron ng pagpapala ang ating kasalukuyan. When we say, we miss you, Lord, the Lord says to us, look for me in your present. Do not cling to the past. Do not cling to yesterday. I am here. I am risen. Ang pangalawa na salita na malapit sa ating puso bilang tao na nabibigyan ng bagong kahulugan sa Ascension ay goodbye. Paalam. Pwede kaya tayong mabuhay ng hindi na tayo mag-goodbye? Kasi masakit. Kung ito'y paalam sa patay o paalam sa mag-OFW o paalam sa apo o anak na mag-aaral sa Maynila, goodbye. Sa unang goodbye, masakit, naiiyak tayo. Pero ayaw nating umiyak. Kaya anong gagawin natin? Titigasan ko na lang mukha ko. Titingin na lang ako sa iba. Di ako titingin sa aalis. Pipigilin ko. Magdadasal na lang ako. Ayaw kong harapin yung katotohanan ng mayroong pamamaalam. Can we really live a life without goodbyes? No. Why not? Because we started our lives on earth by a goodbye. Paano tayo ipinanganak? Nag-goodbye tayo sa sinapupunan. We said goodbye to the womb. And then we saw the light. Life begins with a goodbye. Birth is a goodbye. It is a goodbye to the darkness of the womb so that we can see the light of the sun. Can we live a life without goodbyes? No, my dear brothers and sisters. Because goodbyes are not dead ends. Goodbyes are street signs showing us where to go further. Goodbyes teach us that it is impossible for us to stay together as family. There will be goodbye in friendship, goodbye in family, goodbye in relationships, goodbye in schools, goodbye in corporations, goodbye to cities. But when we have said goodbye, we understand that life does not mean living together in the same city or living together under the same roof. Life means sharing the same spirit, living the same life. Kaya nga po, kahit nag-goodbye na ang Panginoon, we live the Spirit of the Lord. At alam natin, we live like the Lord. May bagong kahulugan ng goodbye. Ang goodbye ay hindi dead end. Ang goodbye ay hindi terminal. Ang goodbye ay street sign showing us where to go further. Pangatlong salita na may connection sa Ascension. Ito po ay palagi kong naririnig sa tatay ko. Huwag kang iiyak. Huwag kang iiyak. Di ba sinasabi din natin sa mga bata, huwag kang iiyak. At pagtanda natin, parang nasa isip natin, hindi ako dapat umiyak. Kapag ikay nasasaktan, saan mo dadalhin yung kirot? Sa ulo o sa damdamin? When you are wounded, allow your wounds to go to your feelings. Feel it. Cry if you need to cry. Because if you will not cry, if you will disconnect your wounds to your feelings, then your wounds will become anxiety. Your wounds will become depression. Your wounds will become sleepless nights. What the Ascension teaches us is this: it is all right to cry. It is better to cry than to be anxious. Tears are better than analysis. And feelings matter more than understanding. At sa paglipas po ng panahon at nawala ang Panginoon, ang mga apostoles ay umiyak din, dinamdam din, dinibdib din yung kanyang pag-alis. Subalit dahil sa pagdidibdib na ito, this emotion, this feeling, they became new persons, stronger persons. So what is the lesson of the Lord's Ascension? Missing a loved one is good because it helps us to grow. Saying goodbye is a blessing because it leads us further in life. To cry is better than anxiety. It is better to bring our wounds to our feelings rather than to the brain and to the intelligence. Because the person who cries is actually an authentic person. Salamat sa Diyos sa biyayang pwede pa tayong umiyak at hindi po nakakahiya ito. Salamat sa Diyos sa biyayang kailangan pang magpaalam sapagkat ang pagpapaalam ay bagong hakbang. Salamat sa Diyos, we still miss loved ones because in missing them, we understand that we are united in the same spirit and we live the same life. So we thank the Lord for His Ascension. We thank the Lord for the capacity to cry. We thank the Lord for all the goodbyes. And we thank the Lord for the nostalgia of the past, because the Lord's name is not I was. The Lord's name is I am, and I am with you always.